Welcome to a sneak preview of ASHRAE's eLearning course. And the title of this course is The School of Hard Knocks, Controlling Moisture and Humidity in Buildings. And this sneak preview is going to be narrated by two folks, myself, Lou Harriman of Mason Grant Consulting, and also my colleague, Terry Brennan of Camroden Associates. We were two of the many dozen professionals that contributed information to this e-learning module and to the information collected by both the Environmental Protection Agency and by ASHRAE. The fact of the matter is, moisture problems are common in buildings, and we know this because during the 1990s, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency did a survey of 100 buildings throughout the U.S., and at that time of the survey, of those 100 buildings, about 83% noted that they'd had moisture problems at some point during their history, and at the time of the survey, 43% had current moisture problems. So what we can gather from that is that moisture problems are not an uncommon problem in buildings. And because of this, the ASHRAE organization, all of us volunteers within ASHRAE and also the Environmental Protection Agency have helped the building community try and figure out what to do to avoid these kind of problems. And this course is the result of that collaboration. To begin with, we'll look at some of the information collected by ASHRAE. About 16 years ago or so, a group involving Technical Committee 112 put together the ASHRAE Humidity Control Design Guide, a very extensive collection of information from a wide variety of professionals about the subject of humidity control. And then broadening that about 7 years ago, the ASHRAE community, again, Technical Committee 112, Moisture Management and Buildings, collected a little bit broader perspective on buildings as a whole, not just humidity, but the buildings' enclosures themselves. Along with that, the Environmental Protection Agency was developing and published in 2013 moisture control guidance for building design, construction, and maintenance. And from the joining of this guidance, both from ASHRAE and EPA, comes a collaborative effort to help folks with professional development in an e-learning module. And that is what we're previewing today in this sneak preview, The School of Hard Knocks, Lessons Learned About the Problems of Humidity Control in Buildings and Moisture Control. What we're going to talk about is four of the 12 things that this three-hour course includes. If we look at the e-learning course as a whole, it's pretty extensive. It goes on for 3 hours, and it's self-paced, and it has a considerable number of subjects. We talk about mold in general, how, why, and where it grows in buildings, and several other major areas of concern. And what we're going to do today is give you briefly two items from the architectural design and then two items from the maintenance world of maintenance and operations of building. So with that, I'm going to turn the narration over to my colleague, Terry Brennan.
Thanks, Lou. The first topic here is air leakage at the roof line. This is a probably the largest leak in many buildings, and it's one that can be fixed pretty easily in design and with some difficulty in retrofit. The problem occurs when there are air leaks at the building. If you look at the image on the right, why the roof membrane does not connect to walls, you can see there's trusses, and it's looks like a gypsum board wall. And the gypsum board goes up, and they've made a pretty good effort actually at sealing around the truss, but still you can see daylight through the gypsum board. That's the place where we find the air leaks. In the image on the left, an infrared image where the brighter yellow colors show warm surfaces up at the where the roof meets the wall, you see a bright line. That's air leakage leaking out of the building in cold weather. the way to think about this in design, and if you're actually faced with solving a problem in a building, is to take a section through the building, and you should be able to trace an air barrier, some material that's forming an air barrier, completely from the center of the roof over to the roof wall connection and down through the wall and into the foundation. If you can't do that without lifting your pen from the page, then you have a problem in the air tightness of the building. There are ways to actually measure this, and there are ways to find the air leaks. The Air Barrier Association of America has published a standard method for testing building enclosures, doing a blower door test to determine whether or not they meet an air tightness standard. This happens to be a good a standard that's very useful for big buildings because it specifically addresses the number of issues that are found in larger buildings. This is the photo on the left is a picture of the fans, test fans used to blower door test a building and determine how air tight it is. And that's something that can be done partway through construction on portions of the building, on mock-ups. And finally, when the entire building is completed, even very large buildings can be tested. On the right, following ASTM E1186, a standard for locating air leakage, this uses theatrical fog with the building pressurized. And you can see in the image a person using a wand, a tube that's blowing theatrical fog up in the roof wall connection. And if there are leaks in it, then you will see them on the see the fog on the outside. This is an example of fog leaking out from a mock-up in a top floor corner room of a building. The next topic is keeping rainwater out of the building. The image that we first see here shows obviously a garage has been removed from the wall of a building, and you see a right where the eave of the garage sloped roof meets the wall, the plywood is all rotted and decayed because there was no flashing to keep the rain from getting behind the siding and the building paper on the wall. The solution to that is a kick-out flashing, which captures that water at the bottom of the slope and diverts it into the gutter instead of letting it run behind the siding and down into the wall. The in the image on the right, you can see that we have a place where there's no building paper. The building paper is the backup moisture protection layer behind the siding on the building. And obviously from where the red circle is, you can see there's no building paper there to provide that protection. This is a section through a building that really is just showing the red dashed line, which would be the building paper, and also called the drain plane, so that any moisture that gets through the brick veneer ends up not being able to get into the building past that red dashed line, because that's a moisture impermeable layer. And it's put together so that the water will drain down it. And then the green dashed line shows a flashing that will collect any excess moisture and drain it out of the wall system, in this case, onto a roof system below.
Thanks, Jerry. Now we'll move on to a couple issues in HVAC, but these are issues a little bit from the design side, but really more on the operational side. And what I'm going to begin with here is information from one of the ASHRAE fellows, a colleague of ours, Don Gatley. And Don has accomplished a number of investigations, 25 years worth of moisture investigations. And over those investigations, he said, really, in terms of operation, it's a little simpler than what you might think. because so many problems, 75 of 79 problems, were caused by too much exhaust air or the makeup air not being dry enough. And the exhaust air is a big issue because oftentimes during operations, the exhaust just runs continuously. Here's an example of a real more recent newspaper story about a middle school, and sure enough, the exhaust hoods were left on by mistake over the holiday break and led to quite a bit of mold. So if we look at this, we can show an illustration of how this happens in a photo that comes from Terry. And what we're looking at there is a cabinet underneath a laboratory, underneath a sink. And you're seeing some mold in the back of that cabinet. And the reason that this is happening is because the building is under suction, so it's under negative pressure. And because of that, humid air is being pulled in through small cracks at the bottom left of that image. And then the humid air flows up and over the cold backside of that cabinet. And because the surface is cold and the incoming humid air is got lots of moisture in it, the moisture is absorbed onto that surface, and that provides the moisture necessary for that mold to grow. This all happens because of the fact that the exhaust fans are left on when there's really nobody left in the building and they don't really need to be on. So that's something that can be done in terms of both control and design, but also in terms of operation. So essentially the advice here is anytime the HVAC system is turned off, then too must also the exhaust air system be turned off as well to make sure that we have no suction and pulling humid air into a building that does not have any humidity control. This also extends another way too, and it gets squarely to the heart of the maintenance issue about changing filters. So what you see on the left-hand side is an outdoor air filter that is thoroughly clogged and really fouled up. As you can see, it's all scrunched. So that's an extreme case. But what happens when that happens is that because the air cannot get through the makeup air system, through the ventilation air system, the exhaust fans pull that air in through the building envelope. And because the building envelope has no preconditioning, of course, you end up having humid air inside a building. Doesn't have to be true. If you keep those filters clean and the outdoor air comes in through the HVAC system, then assuming that the HVAC design has been done in a thoughtful way, the moisture is removed before that humid air gets into the building where it can cause problems. So just in a very humorous vein here, a visual image to help us all remember that once we start seeing birds and feathers coming out of those supplier diffusers, it might be time to think about a nice clean outside air filter. So that's just a little hint of what of the 3 hours of self-paced teaching that ASHRAE and EPA have put together for you in this e-learning course. In addition to that e-learning course, there are quite a bit of printed material that ASHRAE has produced and the EPA. The EPA's moisture control guidance is available for you in both printed form from ASHRAE and in PDF form from the EPA website. And the books that were referenced earlier are also available for you. And to conclude, how you find this e-learning module, you would go very simply to https://elearning.ashrae.org. And when you get to the ASHRAE e-learning site, go ahead and look for the School of Hard Knocks Controlling Moisture and Humidity in Buildings. And that will give you a taste of what many of our colleagues have done over the last 20 years or so to put together information for your benefit so that the buildings that you participate in or that you own or that you operate won't have the difficulties that they've seen in some of the buildings that they've been responsible for. So thank you very much for listening to this for this little teaser, this sneak preview, and we encourage you to make good use of ASHRAE's e-learning modules.